Good morning, everyone. Today we are starting lesson 10 tenses. We start with present continuous tense. Of English grammar book, grade 3. Learning objective. Learning objective of this lesson is to learn about the rules of present continuous tense. Look at these pictures. These people are building a house. In this picture, we can see that people are working something. They are just cutting the wood with a saw. In the next picture, Tarun is swimming in the pool. Means the work is still going on. In this picture, Seema is reading a book. It means still the action is going on. Same in the next picture, Sumit is singing a song. Means still Sumit is singing. These pictures are showing that still the work is going on. It has not been completed. Read the following sentences. Number 1. Mr. Sharma is planting roses. In this sentence, Mr. Sharma is the subject, is the helping verb, and planting is the main verb. Roses is the object. So, whenever the helping verb is there and verb with ing form is given, the sentence belongs to present continuous tense. Number 2. The children are playing in the garden. In this sentence, the subject is the children and the subject is plural. So, we have used the helping verb are. Playing is the main verb in the garden. Garden is the object. So, are playing indicates the sentence belongs to present continuous tense. Number 3. I am eating a chocolate. In this sentence, I is the subject. And then am is an helping verb and it is always used with the subject I. Eating, eat is the main verb and we have added ing with it. So eating shows that the sentence belongs to continuous tense. A chocolate is an object. So whenever the helping verb am is there and the verb with ing form is given, it means the sentence belongs to present continuous tense. Let's see the rule to write and recognize the present continuous tense. For writing the sentences in present continuous tense, we have to start with the subject plus is, am, and are. Is, am, and are the helping verbs. We use the helping verb is when the subject is singular. We use am when the subject is I. And we use are when the subject is plural. Plus V1. V1 is the first form of the verb. Plus ing. We add ing with the first form of the verb so that we can recognize it easily that the sentence belongs to continuous tense plus object. Now it will be more clear with the example. Number 1. Jack is sleeping on his bed. In this sentence, the subject is Jack. Jack is a singular person. So we are using the helping verb is. Sleeping. Sleep is the verb and we have added ing with it. So it has become sleeping on his bed. bed is the object. So this sentence belongs to present continuous tense. Number 2. Seema is writing a letter. In this sentence, Seema is the subject and the subject is singular. So we have written the helping verb is writing. In this word, write is the first form of the verb and we have added ing with it. So it has become writing. A letter. Letter is the object. So this sentence belongs to present continuous tense as the action is going on. Let's revise. Complete the following sentences using present continuous tense. Here the verbs are already given in the box and we have to fill the correct verb in the blanks. Number 1. The telephone dash. The verb is ring. The telephone is singular, so we have to write the helping verb is with it. And the verb is ring because we have to fill the present continuous tense, so we will add ing with the verb ring. It will become ringing. So the sentence will become the telephone is ringing. Number 2. They dash from school and the verb is return. As the subject is plural, so we have to use the helping verb are. And return. Return is the main verb. We have to add ing with it. It will become returning. They are returning from school. Number 3. We dash food. Again, the subject is plural. So we have to use the helping verb are with it. And the main verb eat is given. We have to add ing with it. So it will become we are eating food. Hope the concept of present continuous tense is clear to all of you. Thank you.